Where's the tip? So you'll know that. Alright, so I'll try it with this, and if that works, I'll have that tip. It's the front, I was doing what I'm doing. Oh, show up with pockets now. That's good. Yeah. I need the scooter over here. Yeah, that's what I'm keeping the real truck. So they're up and down to set. Let's make sure all the other ones are still tight. I didn't really tighten them all the way. That's really just, I pre-adjusted it in the garage yesterday. The day before, it was cold yesterday. I didn't even work yet. It's in my pocket. The one that came with the I stuck it in my pocket in case I might get up on the ladder and move it. And sure enough, I did. First thing it is up down there. So I got the little packet of screws and the Allen that came with the pin in my pocket. Let's see if it'll fit. I think it gets a little shorter on the angle. Yeah, okay. And it's getting tight. Okay. So, it's all good. It's mounted. These screws, I feel like they did a good job. So I can shove this extra cable back to there. I can see through the hole. There's enough light in the house. Well, I got that drop light up there. So I can see that it's not. It doesn't matter if it's in wool. The more I have, if I have enough in there, should have done it. Get the biggest one in first. Then, I mean, I can't do the biggest one first. Then the last one is reset button, which I can pull out. I need to. I don't know if I should leave it. No, I'm going to put it in there, and then whatever I use. Get in the garage and work. I ain't been out here waiting too long. It's definitely. Okay. I'm thinking that, what should we just do? doesn't look like a crow. I saw a bug once. Yeah. Okay. Keep this on camera. I was fixing to grab the tablet carried in the garage, but it's a lot of loose connection in there. I'm gonna try it anyway because I'm getting cold. I wanted to kind of watch it for a minute. I guess I can go in the house and watch it. But let's see. Yeah, so not sure where I want to be. Oh, this is where I usually like to put this. Depends on what I'm doing, I guess, but make it a little, not too narrow, it'll fall over, but I'll trip on that thing and kick it. Okay, so I'm just going to get right in that area and see if it'll still work for a minute. Where it's a little, where I can be at the desk and look at that thing. Are we still plugged in? Yeah, we did good this time. This extension cord holds on to stuff better. Okay. Well, I don't want the drill brought in yet. I'll bring it in just to get it out of the cold for a minute. I think there's. Feels much warmer in here. I don't see how it would really be that much warmer with everything wide open, but it does feel warm. Okay. I'm gonna get these tape clips down in the toolbox. Don't need the calipers anymore. Get them out of the way. Wouldn't be nice if I didn't have cold out standing here so much. That's stupid. Okay, now that lid for them screws. Let's have it. Okay. That was a coffee can lid. I had my vessels. A lot of my screws, you know, back when they were easy to. When you bought coffee, it came in a real can, you know. Okay, let's see if this will. Yeah, it's black and white now, and real nighttime it goes black and white. Oh, I never did change the settings. I think it goes back and forth between color and black and white. But it does. Get some of this extra stuff out of my pockets for now. And let's turn that on and see. It hadn't started like acting like it's lost its.
Bought coffee, it came in a real can, you know.
Yeah, it hasn't lost its strength.
And lost its connection. Okay.
Good. Well, it wasn't. Yeah, it tried to go color. I need to get in the settings and turn it back to. I think you have to set it on. I should have left it where it was, the default. I think it was called normal. I set it on automatic. Okay, so scissors and stuff. I don't need them. I think. Okay. Oh. Oh, now that I'm close enough to the table where I can see, there goes a car. Perfect. I could go. Well, like I said, it's kind of notched and. And the next notch down was too low. I had really thought I would. I could see the neighbor's driveway. I mean, it's not a big deal, really. But I didn't. I just thought I would kind of go down low enough to really not even see the neighbor's driveway and see more of the front of my truck. But I noticed that even with it down on their notch, well, it just makes. Well, you can't see who the car's in the street, and you can't see anybody walking up to the mailbox. My mom said, I was saying cards in the, you know, I think of people driving up to the mailbox and stealing your mail and stuff. And trying to steal your identity. But mom said, well, usually when they do it, they're walking. I got to thinking, the one time I heard, I did know somebody was stealing the mail in our neighborhood a few years ago. It was kids, and they were walking around doing it. So I was looking to see if that was in the shot of the other people. So, and I don't know. Well, there was one lady caught stealing mail and stealing identities in our town, and she was put in jail. Well, I don't know if she was walking or driving, but nasty. Well, just imagine what it feels like to be in your throat. That's all the dead gum. That was not just dust. That was sawdust. It tastes and smells like cedar. You know, I guess those things are kind of, the outside, of course, in the wind and the rain and wash them off. But then behind them, me drilling, it was falling out from behind those cedars. Cedar-shaped shingles. That's what they are, cedar-shaped shingles. Anyway, it was falling out from behind them, and it was just loads of sawdust. And it was floating. You know, it wasn't heavy like regular dust. Oh, now it's colored. See, but it keeps doing that, going back and forth. It works so well, I might be able to just turn it on color all the time. I was afraid it wouldn't get good views. And the light on the left that keeps coming on and going off, it's one of those motion sensors. I noticed the other night, well, I saw the reflection. I didn't have we couldn't see the light in the, you know, the way I had the camera out there. It was just, had this camera out here, you know, sizing it up. And, anyway, I could see a light in the window. I had it down low, you know, and I could see a light in the window of my blazer, and I thought, is there a car? I was in the house, and I was like, is there a car behind my stop in the street? And I finally figured out that it's that. That thing came on. When I heard a truck start up, and then it came on. I wonder if it's got sound sensing on it. It's behind enough. The sound is long gone. Oh, okay. It probably came on because somebody walked out in the street from that house. Oh man, my thing's quit. My player's quit. I wonder if I've lost something like my screen again. Let's see. It's reloading.
Sounds like there's a car behind my stop in the street. And I finally figured out that it's that.
It quit reloading, so it's still working. Okay, well, I'm cold, and the only other thing I'd like to do while I have the ladder up there, see if I can find something to put a screw, a piece of wood that I can screw over the, oh, I see something right here, but it's a little thin, and I don't have any cedar, but I might have some oak. I'm going to leave that tablet in here, it's nice and it being out on the hood of the truck. I've got to get back up on the ladder, though. Well, I gotta do something with all this extra cable. So, I'm gonna remember. I'm gonna put some tape over that light switch because I'm gonna end up turning it on. I just about hit it just now. When I go in the house, I hit the switch, you know, but I wasn't going in the house. But I kinda have to get up on the ladder. I don't think I need them here anymore. So, what I'll do is. The ladder's in. Let's see. I guess I'll use this one to get up there. Because I don't know if I need up high to get that light. I left it hanging up there. I'm going to have to shut the door like a little bit. I'll leave the other ladder outside for right now. I'm gonna go in. Oh, the The battery is getting low. It's down to 15%, and that's for real. Okay, so I'm just going to turn this off because I don't have to have this monitor going anymore. I guess playing that much video is a little much for it. Can't get stupid thing. All it does is the YouTube window responds instead of the little buttons. They should step all the time. They do on my phone. They're different on the phone. They're not part of the touch screen. They're part of their own. Let me get that pin out of there. I was talking earlier about you stick a pin under there and that solved my problem. I was about ready to. I had the glue gun out the other day and I was going to glue it in the right place so that, you know, it stays where the camera can see out and everything without having to take it out of here. And to see, you can't get to the back button and all that stuff either with it. When you stand it up, then you can't hardly use it. And so, okay, so let me get over here and get this light. And, oh, I was let loose and went fast. Yeah, so there's the light I need down. And my cable and everything. This, I don't really want to, yeah. It's not coming easily, so, and I've got an ample amount of cable, so when I, I'm gonna do something with this extra cable so that it doesn't. Once I turn off my live stream, I can unplug this and probably put it on this side. After all, that way you can see it. Because you know, if you turn the light on, and these are LEDs, they're not going. I don't think they get hot enough to hurt that, but I didn't want to take a chance. Anyway, the cable is just dangling here. That actually worked out. I still got pretty much what I wanted, you know, although that pigtail's not outside, it's inside the wall, just of a different way than I expected, and, let's see, I'm trying to figure out how I want to hang that, I think I'm just going to do it like that, yeah. That's going over that way. But while I'm still streaming, I want to unplug it. I guess I can. There's nothing to see on the stream now. It's just be what I'm doing in here. Well, I'm gonna go. Oh yeah, I'm gonna go back out there, and that's what I was fixing to do. Find a piece of wood that I can just screw over that. Well, we probably do have some of that stain, but oak is too hard to get screws through. Well, I can drill. I don't have cedar. I started a sentence, always do that. Started a sentence and then didn't finish it. If I had a little kind of a rectangular or square piece of oak that I didn't, you know, think it was good for something important, put it over. I mean, that hole's been there always. As long as we lived in the house, it's probably not going to hurt anything, but it is bigger now. You know, it's cold. I think I'll wait. It's not going to hurt anything for tonight. I'll just do something with this cable here and go ahead and get that other ladder before I forget. Put this one up. I should know if I just leave it up there for now. Okay, let's open you back up. Thank you. just go ahead and pull those cables in, but I thought, well, already I've got the camera over there for what I'm fixing to do. I ought to do that, I guess. But I am going to get them in. I'm still going to have to open the door again. I can see that. I was thinking I could get them in and I'll have to open the door again. But that's not really going to work. So, I'm glad I have those gloves on. Okay. Well, I got off on another. I went out and walked out and tested the security camera before. I think I'll go shut down the live stream now because. You know, I'm not doing anything else outside, and you're not going to see anything. So I'll go do that. And I'll shut it down, and I can take off this microphone bag. And then I'll come back and get up there and do something, kind of hang those wires up out of the way. Well, I did come back, believe, after all. How about that? I see. This time, I noticed the other day when I had it aimed up high, you could never see me unless I got on the ladder. So, I gotta have a cheese stick. I got detained in there. Mom was asking questions, talking about the camera and everything. So I got to kind of talk to her about it and then shut down the live stream. And wash my face and stuff. That old dust from behind those shingles, like I said, I'm pretty sure it tasted like cedar. It wasn't just dust. So I think they've been deteriorating from the back there. Me drilling just made it all come flying out of there. So I'm getting pretty darn hungry, so I'm getting a cheese stick. And I'm just going to hang up the wire, put up my tools, you know what? I was thinking about like a piece of board or something, but you know, you can probably buy probably plastic covers that are made for covering up holes when you hang, when you hang stuff, make holes in the walls for outdoor stuff, wiring of whatever type, you know. But I can find something really cheap that maybe something you can, that you even, instead of having to unscrew it every time you want access to it, maybe just if it was a round thing that would pivot back and forth over that hole, it'd be nice if it actually put it up there in such a way that it makes the water not want to go in the hole, you know. Because if it's just a flat board, water's just going to go behind that board. Unless it's put up there properly like a shingle is, you know. This is really uncomfortable. Starting off here. Well, I'll just turn this. I left it where I thought I was going to be in no time flat. And I wasn't there. Yeah, that doesn't really work out too good trying to make a yeast coasters. That's my good desk. Trying to make a live video and a camera video at the same time. Just can't make you waste time on running around trying to adjust them both. So, I had this cheese stick, and I thought I was getting myself in the picture, but I probably didn't. There. Looks like maybe it's a little low. I can't adjust it. It's really not. I've gotten fairly good at kind of looking up at that camera and, adjusting it, but not that easy to do. I mean, I can't see the screen from here, Yeah, now that my live video's not going, I don't have to worry about. That's how you start reboot the cameras. You unplug it and you plug it back in. So I just unplug that power supply and put it back on the. I don't like it on that side now of the that I have it on of the light. And I'm gonna get me some piece of tape. Tape that light switch up. Cover it up and put a little note on it, leave it on for myself or anybody else. I use that light all the time. Time to think. Thing is, I don't really want to leave a light on all the time because it makes everybody want to turn it off. Oh, what's that light? I'm not going to turn it off. I got the two bulbs. And only one of them has one of those adapters that you can turn it on and off with. I don't think I have another. I don't have another one that has a switch on it like that. So, and what I really would like to do, if I'll probably do it still, put a switch box. Now that I got lots of cable, I can put it wherever I want. I was thinking, while the wires ran, it'd be simplest to put it above that switch. Or I actually have one that's a combo switch, and one switch, one plug. But I really wanted to, you know, at least two, so that I could plug extension cord in there too. But you can always use, like, you know, three ways and stuff. But usually if you plug extension cord in one of them, it'll dangle down and pull the three way out of the wall. Out of the plug. So, heater on. I got a heater up in the front as well. Down here by the door. Of course, the door doesn't shut all the way unless you go step on it, and then you really, it still won't shut all the way. But I got another heater, but I'm not going to dig it out. I'm not going to step here that long. Okay, so you see, I fixed my tripod. It pans real good and up and down real good. And but I'm so used to it not working right, and I grab it by the legs. I can't show that here, but anyway, I've got it on that big lights tripod that I was using. Let's see. Yeah, I don't need to be up real high. I just need to be. I don't know what I'm gonna use to hold that stuff. Let me get over there and look and see what I might need. But one way, and that's pointing towards the bulb, and that makes it touch the bulb. But it's touching the plastic insulation, it's not touching the bulb. It's, and it's like I said, it's LED, so it's not.